My favorite bags video is already pretty old, and since then I have reviewed a lot of bags, so it was about time that I show you my current top 5 bag video. In 2020, a lot happened, as we all know, and due to the lockdown, I personally wasn't able to review as many bags as I would like to have. So, with that in mind, I looked at all of the bags that I reviewed in 2020 and I felt like, okay, let's take a look at all of the bags of 2019 and 2020 and pick out my top 5 bags of those 2 years. These are not my favorite bags of all time, but basically all of the bags that I consider to be a good choice or that I personally like the best in those 2 years. So the first 4 bags that I will mention in this top 5 video don't have a particular order. For me, they are all great, and just the last bag that I will mention in this video is my absolutely favorite bag of 2020. So starting with the first bag, this is a photography bag, and I was actually deciding between the Peak Design Everyday Backpack and the Wanderer Provoke backpack. The Wanderer Provoke backpack I used on my documentary when I went to Indonesia to show you how bags are being made. And therefore I tested that bag out intensively, but that doesn't mean that the Peak Design Everyday backpack isn't as great. Both of them are incredible backpacks for photography gear. However, I personally feel that the Wanderer Provoke is a better hybrid backpack. It's more easily transformable to an everyday carry bag, and it's easier to use it for other items or day-to-day scenarios compared to the Peak Design Everyday bag. With the Everyday bag from Peak Design, you basically organize the bag or customize the bag with all of the dividers to your personal gear. But once everything is set, you can easily transform the bag to transport or pack anything other than the equipment that you set up the dividers for. But with the Wanderer Provoke, there is this roll top expandable top loading compartment in addition to the cube with all of your camera gear. With that in mind, it's much more easier to use the top compartment for any other items that are not photography related, and it adapts better to other items that you might need on a day-to-day basis. Imagine going to the grocery store after your shoot or after your work. It's easier to pack those groceries into the Wanderer compared to the Peak Design, because everything inside the Peak Design is basically set. You can obviously just take out the dividers and then generate more space inside the Peak Design, but it's much more cumbersome than on the Wanderer. And more importantly, in the Wanderer, you can just take out the cube and use the bag as a regular carry-on backpack. So for me, it's like the Wanderer Provoke is basically 60% camera bag, or maybe 50% camera bag and 50% everyday carry bag, while the Peak Design is maybe 80% camera or technical equipment bag and just 20% everyday carry bag. So for me, the balance is better on the side of the Wanderer, because I want to use that bag for more use cases than just carrying camera gear. So that's my very first pick of my favorite bags in 2020. So I just mentioned that you can use the Wanderer Provoke as a carry-on bag. So the next pick would be a carry-on bag. And there are 2 bags that impressed me a lot in 2019 and 2020. One of which was the Topo Design Travel Pack 40 liter, and the other one was the Akido Oxner. So the Topo Design 40 liter is a massive bag. It's 40 liters, but what surprised me, it just didn't feel like 40 liters. I was able to pack so much stuff, but it wasn't heavy. It wasn't overloaded because it has so many compartments. And although the colors might be not everyone's cup of tea, but it was very refreshing in the sea of all of the black bags. So that bag impressed me quite a lot. The next one, speaking of very comfortable, is the Akido Oxna. That design of the bag or the look of the bag is also not everyone's cup of tea. Personally, I don't see that bag being as a very pretty bag or a very cool bag. However, just with the Akido Acra bag, I was amazed. I was actually blown away how comfortable that bag is to carry. And with the Oxna, Akido actually made some significant improvements over the Acra. Is it Acra or Acra? I'm not sure if it's Acra or Acra. However, this bag is the Oxna is so incredibly comfortable to carry. The shoulder straps feel very good when the bag is fully loaded and you carry it around the airport. And it has this mesh outside where you can just stick some items that you quickly need, like a jacket or when you are at the airport, a water bottle or some snacks that you just want to quickly store away when you need your hands free. So I found that to be a very good feature. And overall, the bag, together with the packing cubes, is incredibly well to pack, to load, to unpack, and it's a very useful and very well made bag. So I was deciding between these two, and it's kind of a cop out because I'm not 100% sure which of these two bags I like better. But currently I'm leaning a little bit more on the side of the Akido because with the Topo design being 40 liters, I feel like it's not everyone's bag because it's just too big. Obviously, there's a smaller one, but that I didn't test. So I only choose between the 40 liter Topo design and the Akido Oxna. And the Akido Oxna is a little bit smaller. It has a, albeit boring design, I feel like it's more suitable for more people. Even if you go with the smaller Topo design travel pack with the black colorway, it still has like this boxy shape to it, which not everyone might like. So the Akido is very comfortable, very well made. It doesn't necessarily overwhelm you with too many features. And yeah, the only downside that I can currently think of is that the bag looks boring, but that's in the eye of the beholder. So I would say it's 55% the Akido Oxna and 45% I am leaning towards the Topo design. So both bags, great choices, but if I want to stick with the top five, it's the Akido Oxna. The next bag that I want to talk about in this top five is an everyday carry bag. And I actually noticed over the last month, the last year, when people ask me, hey, I want a good value everyday carry bag that I can also use for the gym, I noticed that I always land on this bag, which is the Air Duffel Pack. Not the normal version, but the X-Pack version. The normal version of the Air Duffel Pack is great. It has, just like the X-Pack version, it has great features, great compartments, a very, let's say, unique loading style. I personally prefer clamshell opening bags, and with clamshell opening bags, there are also top loading bags, hybrid bags that have top loading and clamshell, but this is a duffel style. This is not something new, but for backpack, or an everyday carry backpack, I feel like this is pretty cool. Furthermore, it has a shoe compartment, which makes it great for the gym, or even items that are wet or dirty and you don't want to mess up all of the items in the main compartment, then you can just stick it into the shoe compartment. Or if you carry camera gear, for instance, you could pack like very soft items like a sweater in the shoe compartment and generate a soft cushion at the bottom to keep your camera gear protected that is inside the main compartment. So overall, very good features. The Cordura version is the cheaper version and it's still a great bag, but it's also a little bit usual or boring. So I would always recommend, if you want to go with the Air Duffel Pack, buy the X-Pack version. The only downside with X-Pack is that it's a little bit more noisy, the material. So it has this kind of crinkly noise to it that you might need to get used to. But to me personally, X-Pack feels much more premium and looks in my eyes, a little bit better than Kodura. So if you're going for the duffel pack, definitely go with the X-Pack version. So overall, I would say the duffel pack has great build quality, enough cool features to not overwhelm you, but still give you a good way to organize all of your items. It has the shoe compartment and overall a very cool looking bag. The only thing that you need to keep in mind, it has this very long shape to it. So depending on your height, this bag might look a little bit overwhelming or out of place on your back. So that's the only thing that I can think of to keep in mind that might be a downside with that bag. But other than that, I definitely can highly recommend the Air Duffel Pack X-Pack version. So I mentioned that the duffel pack is a little bit taller, a little bit bigger, and therefore looks a little bit overwhelming on a shorter person. And some of you might know that I'm only 170 centimeters tall, so not as tall, and most bags look a little bit bigger on my back. So the next bag in my top 5 is the Alchemy Equipment Carryology Collaboration Backpack, which is the AEL222. This might surprise some of you if I mention this in combination with a bag being too tall or too big on my bag, because the AEL222 bag is a carry-on friendly bag that is around 30 liter-ish in capacity. So it's fairly big just by the numbers. However, I noticed that the bag being a carry-on friendly bag and having that specific size looks, to my eyes, very flattering on my back. It doesn't look that big. It feels very comfortable, even fully loaded when you use it as a carry-on bag. But with most carry-on bags, I usually feel like, oh, they are so big, I am never be able to use this as an everyday carry bag because it would be just too overwhelming. But for some reason, the shape and the choices of materials make the bag not as overwhelming on my back compared to other 30 liter carry-on friendly bags. So I was actually able to use this bag not only as a carry-on friendly backpack, but also as an everyday carry bag for work. Plus, all of the materials and the design overall are incredible. It's a collaboration bag with Carryology, so they went all out with the materials and with the design. The interior has this bright orange, which looks awesome. Overall, I must say, if there is a downside, there aren't that many compartments. You have a laptop slot, this small see-through compartment at the top, a quick access compartment here and there, but overall it's not as many compartments as some of you would like. But I would argue these are enough compartments to store all of your items, organize them well, and not be overwhelmed to a point where you are like, oh, where did I put this specific item? And the bright orange definitely does help you to find all of your stuff inside the main compartment more easily. What I found is that this bag being a little bit more suitable for the everyday carry lifestyle and it not being so overwhelming on my back, it is 30 liters, but sometimes it doesn't feel that big when you try to pack it for carry-on items, because it has this kind of shape where it goes smaller to the bottom. So this is probably the reason why it does feel less overwhelming on my back and more flattering than other bigger carry-on bags. So this shape to it makes loading a lot of wider or bigger items, for instance, packing cubes with sweaters or jeans, so those packing cubes being a little bit wider, makes it a little bit more difficult to load inside. So that's something to keep in mind. So maybe consider this bag more of a 28 liter bag or 27. But other than that, if you're looking for an everyday carry bag for work and stuff like that, that you potentially could also use for a business trip, one day overnighter, then this is an incredible bag. It has, due to all of the materials and due to it being a limited edition Cariology collaboration backpack, it has a pretty high price tag. But for me, I feel like this is more of a collector's piece and investment item due to all of the great fabrics. Therefore, this is definitely in my top 5, the Alchemy Equipment Cariology Collaboration Backpack AEL222. Wow, that was a mouthful. Okay, now to my absolute favorite bag of 2020 and 2019. This bag, yeah, it impressed me a lot, and I overall like what this brand is doing in terms of design language and design philosophy and what materials they are using. And to me, everything that they are making feels very refreshing design-wise, feature-wise. So my absolute favorite bag of 2020 and 2019 is the Black Amber Forge. And specifically the bigger version, the carry-on friendly size version that is transformable to a smaller capacity for everyday carry use. To me, this bag is a very unique and, to my eyes, refreshing design. The materials are also incredible, the Hyperlon, and how all of the slots are laid out and the compartments, how you open this bag suitcase style. This is all incredible. For instance, the main quick access compartment in the front, because this bag is useful as a backpack and as a briefcase mode, inside this quick access compartments there are so many small slots that are laid out for briefcase mode, which means that as soon as you turn the bag over and use the bag as a backpack, none of the items slide to the bottom. They all stay in place. The bag doesn't get bulky at the bottom because everything just slides down and accumulates at bottom. Everything stays in place inside that quick access compartment or organizer compartment in the front. Same goes with the inside of the main compartment. There are so many slots that make all of the items arranged properly that even if you use it in briefcase mode or if you use it in backpack mode, nothing just slides around inside. And still, it has a good amount of compartments that don't overwhelm you, or if there are a couple of compartments, they are all in one place and have see-through mesh pockets, so you find all of your items very quickly. And whenever I have to carry lots of items for, like, when I'm doing remote editing on set and I have to bring lots of equipment with me, I can transform the bag to this carry-on friendly size and fit all of my editing gear and camera gear inside, and the bag still looks like a normal bag and doesn't scream like, oh, there's lots of equipment inside. Or even when I'm traveling, I use this as a carry-on friendly bag. Once I arrive at my destination, I take out all of the packing cubes, use the compression straps, make it smaller, and then it's a work bag. That's incredible. I love this flexibility with the bag. Downside of this bag is, because Black Amber uses so many heavy-duty materials, there are lots of compartments, slots, zippers, buckles, and stuff like that, this bag is fairly heavy when empty. This is definitely one of the biggest downsides of the Black Amber Forge, and definitely something you need to keep in mind. But I feel like, for me personally, all of the positives definitely, no pun intended, outweigh this one negative of the bag. The bag is very comfortable to carry, even with that weight of the bag itself in mind, and when the bag is fully loaded with all of my gear. The shoulder straps feel incredible, and even if you are traveling with the bag and a rolling case, for instance, there's a pass-through in the back panel and then you can just put it onto your rolling case. I have done this plenty of times, because whenever the Forge is full with all of my equipment, I cannot fit all of my clothing, so I have to take a rolling case with me in that situation. So yeah, for me personally, this is one of my favorite bags, the Black Amber Forge. I can highly recommend this bag because the look is cool, the build quality is cool, all of the features are great. And I need to mention this, it is very heavy. There is a smaller version of the Black Amber Forge, which looks pretty cool. I haven't tested it, but I feel like I would rather spend a little bit more and deal with a little bit more heft to the bag and be able to transform the bag to many more purposes. Yeah, that's my favorite bag of 2020 and 2019. All right, so those were my top five bags of 2019 and 2020. And as mentioned, the first four bags or four and a half bags, they aren't in a particular order. I like all of them and I can recommend all of them very much. The Forge, however, that's definitely of all of the bags, my favorite bag so far. And I would definitely like to know from you, what are your top five bags of 2020 and yeah, also 2019, because obviously none of us have been using bags that much while being at home. So let me know, which are your top five or just top three bags of 2019 and 2020? Just let me know in the comment section below. And yeah, I hope all of you are safe and healthy at home. I wish you some great holidays and Happy New Year, despite we all, at least in Germany, we are back in lockdown. I hope all of you are safe and healthy. And yeah, like always, if you have any more questions, comment below. And if you enjoyed this video, click the like button. And please feel free to subscribe to my channel and click that little bell icon so you won't miss next videos. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my Instagram at youknowthebow to see behind the scenes and votings and stuff like that, or just pictures of bags and travel related items. And last but not least, thank you so much for watching all of my videos, and I see you in the next video. Thank you very much.